Upendra, working as an associate professor in the department of PCE, St. Martin's Engineering College. So today I would like to give a brief presentation on antennas and wave propagation subject. So this, as per JNTU, we have 5 units. Among all the 5 units, I'd like to discuss briefly on the topic, one of the units called antenna arrays. So before going into antenna arrays, let us discuss what is an antenna and then learn about antenna array. Antenna is simply a mechanical setup or mechanical arrangement which produces or deals about the electromagnetic wave signals. This setup either can receive an electromagnetic signal and send or transmit a radio electromagnetic signal. The signal can be of any frequency depending upon the user necessity. It can be of any frequency. It can be of a lower frequency or a very low frequency or even at higher frequencies like microwave frequencies, which deals about the gigahertz signals also. Right, now coming to antenna array. What do you mean by antenna array? Why are we going for an antenna array? See, for example, I have a basic antenna which is XYZ. If this antenna can give me a signal of 15 km on either side, 7.5 km on this side and 7.5 km on this side. An antenna XYZ is giving me 15 km of signals on all 360 degrees. But whereas my user, I'm at nearly about 20 km on this side. Now I cannot find an electromagnetic wave where I have weak signal, which is approximately zero. At this case, what I need to do is, I need to have another antenna nearby the user so that he will also be having, or the probability of finding an electromagnetic wave will be 1. The maximum probability is always 1. It cannot be more than 1. So, in order to overcome such cases, I am also adding another antenna to the previous antenna. So, I am adding another antenna. For example, I have added same antennas XYZ1, XYZ2, 3 and 4. When I am adding 4 antennas on a common line, each antenna was giving me 15 km of signal. When I added 4 antennas of similar characteristics, it can give me more than 4 times. So it may be more than 60 plus kilometer signal will be coming. So therefore, now let us come into the definition. Antenna array is a group of similar antennas which gives you more radiation on all 360 degrees so that every user will be having a huge signal or a strong signal. This is one of the major advantage and application of an antenna array. See, antenna arrays are of many types. We have basic antenna array and the huge antenna arrays which are in mechanical setup. The arrangement differs from basic upon the mechanical arrangement. The first one, basic antenna array, is called as parasitic antenna array. So what do you mean by parasitic antenna array? Parasitic antenna array is simply, for example, I have 3 antennas in an antenna array. So let us go to the definition again. This is the array axis. This is array axis which passes through the center of all the antennas. Like 1, 2 and 3 are the 3 antennas in the array. So I am taking this one as a system. Whole of these 3 antennas are together called as a single antenna, which is called parasitic antenna array, for example, instance. Now I have to give input to one of the antennas among these 3, and all 3 antennas will radiate the electromagnetic waves into free space. Now where should I give the input? That is the case here. So whenever the source is giving input to the antennas present inside them, for example, if I am giving the input for the second antenna, then this particular individual second antenna is called driven element. Any antenna which takes input in a given antenna array is always called driven element. And all the antennas which are on the left side of it are called reflectors. And the other antennas on the other side are called directors. Right? So there are 3 types of individual antennas in any given antenna array: driven elements, reflectors, and directors. The antenna which takes the exact input from the source is always called as a driven element. And the other antennas on the left side of it are called reflectors. And all the other antennas on the other side are called directors. So the basic antenna, parasitic antenna, has one reflector, one driven element, one director. The number of directors can be increased, whereas
the number of reflectors and driven elements cannot be increased. They are always one each. That means you can apply the input only for one antenna. You only have one reflector. You have one plus more directors depending upon your strength of the signal. If you want to have bigger strength of signal, you increase your number of directors. So if you want to have signal for 60 kilometers, you increase your number of directors. If you want to receive a signal which is from 100 kilometers, you always, if you want to go for a satellite communication, if you want to deal with this, then you increase your number of directors. So this is a basic parasitic antenna. And coming to the extension of a parasitic antenna array is my topic now, which is called Yagi-Uda antenna. So Yagi-Uda antenna is an antenna who is using every day in day-to-day life. Now this antenna is nothing but my TV reception antenna. TV reception means, in older days, nowadays we are using parabolic antennas, but if we go to the previous olden days, everybody used to use an Yagi-Uda antenna for our TV signals, which looks like this way, if you can remember, which is this, which was our roof, top roof. So this second one is called as driven element, because now this is one point, this is one point. For these two, I apply my input. This is called reflector, and these are called directors. Here the number of directors are more, but the basic setup is always resembles a parasitic antenna, which has one driven element, one reflector, and minimum number of one directors. So see here, the beauty of this Yagi-Uda antenna is, the Yagi-Uda is something with the name of the scientist, Japanese scientist. He is from Japan. On his name he has invented this. So the Yagi-Uda antenna can take signals below from 3 MHz to 30 MHz, or even sometimes even more than this, but the better signal receptions are from 3 MHz to 30 MHz. Right. Now the driven element is taking the input. Now this is an antenna internally, which is made up of aluminium. So now this driven element radiates electromagnetic waves towards the reflector. It radiates electromagnetic waves towards the reflector. See the working. Here with the electromagnetic waves coming out from the driven element and come to the reflector on only one side. The radiation is not possible or do not come on the other side. Now what do we call this antenna which is sending electromagnetic waves only one direction? So this is called directional antenna. So directional antenna means it only sends signals in which direction I want and do not send any signals on which direction I don't want. So I don't want the radiations on this side. So therefore my driven element is a directional antenna. It is sending electromagnetic waves only on this direction, and the electromagnetic waves that are coming towards the reflector are enough to put this reflector antenna into on condition. On condition or to drive it into the, again the reflection starts from the reflector antenna. The reflector antenna is also a directional antenna and radiates electromagnetic waves onto the this side. Now all these electromagnetic waves will drive all the directors into on condition, and now these directors will give you the maximum radiation. So this is an important word what you need to remember here. The maximum radiation is always bothered about the or in view of the directors. The directors are moved into on position by using the signals coming out from the reflector. The reflector itself is on by using the driven element. The driven element is taking the input from the source. So therefore, the input source and your maximum radiation are directly proportional. If you are giving your more input, your maximum radiation is more. Or you can also say it is also directly proportional to the number of directors. So therefore, Yagi-Uda antenna is simply an antenna whose maximum radiation depends on the number of directors. Now let us see the radiation pattern of a Yagi-Uda antenna. The radiation pattern of a Yagi-Uda antenna is simply in a unidirectional method. So if I am taking the process here. So now I have directors here. If I can look at the screen here, this is my Yagi-Uda antenna, this is my driven element, this is my reflector, and these are my directors. Initially it is moving this reflector into on position, and the reflectors are moving all the directors into on position. So therefore the maximum radiation is in this direction. The maximum radiation is always expressed by using a major lobe.
on the radiation pattern.
So now what does this indicate? So if we can see, initially the driven element is moving the reflected torsion and thereby the directors. So all due to this intervention of all the antennas, I also have some error which is represented by the minor lobes. Right. If I can see this radiation pattern, if 100 watts is total power, if 100 watts is total power, nearly 90 to 96% will be in the major lobe of the power, total power, and 3 to 5% of the total power will be carried out by the minor lobes, which is negligible. So therefore, a Yagi Uda antenna can receive or transmit signals with high accuracy. And that is the reason we are using them in the TV signals or TV reception signals. If Yagi Uda antenna is not good or showing not much efficiency, then we cannot see a TV or no channel will be coming out, which uses the satellite communication. We are dealing with a signal which is somewhere in 1000 lakhs of kilometers from the above. The only reason is the reception of the Yagi Uda antenna is very well. And coming to future scope, now as of day today, the Yagi Uda antennas are giving you 3 to 5% noise. So the advancement of this is a parabolic dish antenna, which we are using now. Parabolic dish antenna is, see for example, if I am talking about the Airtel dish, which is like this. So we are using this in day to day life. Now this is nothing but every user at our home is using an individual dish. In the previous cases, our network operator, who is providing the dish for us, he used to have a parabolic dish antenna. He used to receive the signals and he will be sending the signals to your home by using a cable, a dish cable. But now he will be getting an efficient signal, whereas when it is traveling to n number of users, the signal quality, or you can simply say SNR ratio, goes decreasing, signal to noise ratio. In order to overcome that, now what people have identified is a parabolic dish antenna. Why don't each and every user use his own dish so that we'll be having a good quality signal? And those antennas are parabolic dish antennas. We'll be discussing this in the coming units. Okay. So therefore, coming to the applications, they are used in TV reception signals. Okay. So coming to the conclusion, the future scope of these parabolic dish antennas can also be much further divided by coming into the MIMO antennas also, multiple input and multiple output antennas. Right. Applications, they are used in TV reception, very wide application, TV reception, and also Yagi Uda antenna is used as a basic antenna. It is also used as a basic antenna for the MIMO antennas. Okay. Or you can also use it in the microstrip antennas. Thank you.